emotional breakdown, God, because you called us, you've given us a high call, and we need to press in, God, for that,
yes,
that high call, God. And so we ask you to be the driver of the vehicle that we will use on this journey in the name of Jesus,
yes,
God. We ask you as we go on this journey in life, God, that you cover us because you've called the apostle, you've called many that are listening tonight, you've given them a high call, and it's a price, God. So cover him and cover those that are listening tonight. Cover us, God, with the blood as we go on this journey, God. We thank you, Father God. We reject any form of malfunction.
Yes,
we reject any form,
Jesus name,
of evil, God, in,
yes,
the name of Jesus. Father God, we commit our life into your able,
yes,
hands in the name of Jesus. Lord, let the angel of the Lord go before us. Let your archangels, God, go before us in ranking order to make our way prosperous and safe, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, we declare that no weapon of the enemy fashioned against us shall be able to prosper, and every tongue that rises against us in judgment is already condemned. We stand on your word, Father God. We give you glory and honor and praise, Father God, for your goodness and your mercy. We bless your holy name.
Yes,
we glorify your holy name, Father. We believe, God, that you will speak from heaven tonight to the apostle, the those that are listening tonight, God. We believe that you're speaking even now, God, as we sit in your presence, Father. We bless you, Father. We thank you for directions, God, that we need next steps, Father. We ask you for next steps, God. We ask that you would help us to penetrate the hard places, God, the hard places for many of us in business, that you penetrate, God. Show us how to penetrate the hard places at the gates, God, in the name of Jesus. Many of us are called to the marketplace, Father God, and we know that there's an open and effectual door, but your word says there are many enemies, Father God.
Yes.
So we ask that you show us, God, position us, Father, so that we may walk in those gates, God, in the name of Jesus. Bless your name, God.
Yes.
We thank you, God, for many of us, this high call, God, comes with sacrifices. And so, God, we don't ask to see all the hard part, but we ask that you would give us the wisdom and to endure, God, for you said that we needed to endure. So, God, we thank you, God, that you'll show us how to endure.
Yes.
We thank you that you are dispatching angels even as we pray, God, to go forth and bring in that which we need. We thank you that you're dispatching angels to go into the uttermost parts of the earth, beneath the earth, beneath the sea, in the second and third heavens, God, and they're mowing on our behalf, and we give you glory, and we give you honor and praise.
Yes.
Holy Ghost, we thank you that you go before us, and that you're making every crooked place straight, and that you are indeed breaking in pieces the gates of brass, and you are breaking down walls for us, and we glorify you, God, and we,
yes,
magnify your name. We give you glory tonight. We thank you, God, for this new season that we're entering in, the year 5777. Father God, it is amazing. I know that it's so significant tonight. And so, Father God, I send these words forth as your climbing winds in the realm of the Spirit to demolish and to destroy the enemy's camps. Cause the four winds of heaven to blow, God, and destroy conquering winds. For we decree that this prayer and every other prayer that we will ever pray take on the characteristics, and every devil's camp is blown up tonight,
yes,
in the name of Jesus. We declare that Satan and his cohorts are now under the footstool of Jesus. And before we end this prayer, Satan, we send you notice now to cough up the spit on everything that you've held back from us, our finances, our wealth, our joy. We command you to cough it up, spit it out, loose it, and release it, and let it go in the name of Jesus. You're a liar, you're a foul spirit, and we command you to cough up all that you held and spit it from us. Release it now and let it go. We bless you, Father, as we receive, God. We're positioning ourselves right now for death, abounded miracles, that you may be glorified, God, yes. And we may carry out your purpose in this earth. We give you glory. We thank you, Father, for this opportunity to just sit and talk for a moment and declare your word and to praise you and to honor you. As we carry on tonight, God, we carry on and believe that you hear us and the answers are on its way. In Jesus' name we pray. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, Father God. Father, we just thank you. Tonight, I just wanted to share a little bit more about what I believe God is speaking to us in the earth tonight, in the world, what's going on right now. And I believe it's highly significant. I won't spend any time talking about world events, but everything tonight is working together for good, including the presidential election. But tonight, I just want to talk a little bit about what I have heard as I'm listening to the prophetic, to the prophets around the earth and the apostles that are speaking tonight, what they hear God saying. And the Bible says that we believe the prophets, so shall we prosper. And I believe in the prophetic word and the apostolic word that's coming forth tonight. It's bear witness with my spirit. And I just want to share a little bit tonight for those that are listening. And I just need to just calm down a little, because when I get in the presence
thank
of
you.
God,
thank you.
I can't stop crying, and I just can't stop. When I get in the presence of God, I break, I melt. When I get in the presence of God, so tonight I just want to share a little, if I can get it out, about what I believe is happening and going on over the next month or two. And we're entering into the new year, beginning October, Rosh Hashanah. And in this particular month, I want to just share with some people about where we are. You know, as we enter the Hebrew calendar, we're entering in the middle of the month. There are 29 days in September. I just want to talk a little bit about the month of September according to the Hebrew calendar. This is the month of Elul, E-L-U-L. And the characteristics of this month means that, simply that, it's a month that has the characteristics of meaning the king is in the field this month. And so I just want to share tonight what Elul is. It's actually the sixth of the 12 months of the Jewish calendar. Elul is called the month of repentance, the month of mercy, and the month of forgiveness. Now, Elul follows the previous month, which is Tammuz and Av, and we just come out of Av, which was August. Really was the month that we were to get before the Lord and just begin to talk to God. And that was the month where the children of Israel basically missed the blessings of God. That was the month that the children of Israel did not get that opportunity to cross over. And now it follows the month of Elul. This is the month that the king is in the field. This is according to 2 Samuel 10 and 1. So I want you to, it's important that you know the word of God for yourself. 2 Samuel 10 and 1. If any of you have your Bibles tonight, I just want to go over that scripture with you tonight, because it's not enough to hear the word of God, but you need to know it for yourselves. The month of Elul talks about the king being in the field. And a little history of that is that during the month, once a year, the king would come in the field. And I want to go to that word first, and then we'll go from there. Second Samuel 10 and 1. And it came to pass after this, that the king of the children of Ammon died, and Hanun his son reigned in his stead. Then I make sure I'm in the right place. That's it, 10 and 1. And then David said, I will show kindness unto Hanun, the son of Nahash, and as his father show kindness. And David went to comfort him by the hand of his servants for his father. And David's servants came into the land of the children of Ammon. At this time, David was king. And the Bible is showing here when David actually went into the field to comfort. And so this month, it signifies a very high holy month, because it's actually the month that we're moving in preparation for the high holy days of Tisha B'Av. And forgive my lack of Hebrew dialect. But this is the month when Moses ascended into Mount Sinai as well. So this month is highly significant, very, very significant. This is also the month when Moses received the second tablets of the covenant. These days were days when God revealed himself to the Jewish people with great, great mercy. Elul is the month of God. G-A-D. This is a transitional month. Now hear me, it's a transitional month because this is the last month of the new year. And this precedes the fall feast. This month is very, very significant, people, because this is also the month where there's expectations of good fortune throughout this entire month. Rewards will begin to manifest according to what you've done this month. The word Elul forms an interesting phrase, and it is in the Songs of Solomon, and that's Solomon 6 and 3. So, write this down and go in and read this for yourself. That word says, I am my beloved, and my beloved is mine. In Hebrew, the first letters of each word, and that phrase spells out this month, E-L-U-L. Now, the Jewish have a very interesting way to describe this month. They say, this is the month where the king is in the fields. So as you begin to understand the meaning of this phrase, you'll see how God wants to relate to us during these days. Remember, this is a month where we're now transitioning into the new year. And so let me just give you a little bit of history. Throughout the time when the king decided to come into the field, we all know that according to the word of God, back in the day when the king lived in the palace, he was protected by armed guards and iron gates. In order to have an audience with the king, you better have an appointment. Understand protocol, understand how to dress correctly. It was very important that when you went to stand before the king, that you were on point. And you were then ushered through security, and it was layers of security. And it says here, it was in a magnificent palace. And as you entered into the throne room, it was very, very intimidating. Imagine, remember Esther. She was married to the king. And the Bible says she prepared when she went to the king because she needed a favor from the king. And the Bible says she didn't go haphazardly. She prepared and she thought that thing through. And she was groomed by the eunuch. And so we know that in order to stand before the king, it was important that you have, again, be on point. You need to be very, very careful what you said and what you did because the king was on the throne. And so one month each year back in the Old Testament, there was an opportunity for people to come before the king. And so what would happen is you would go out to the king, and there would be a eunuch that would go through the community, the valley, and say, the king is in the field. And why am I sharing all of this? The king in the day went out of his royal tent, and anyone wanted to see him were welcome. And when the eunuch howled, the king was in the field, the king was accessible to his people. Well, God is very accessible, especially during the month of Elul, during this particular month. So it says, I'm reading the word from Apostle Chuck Pierce. It says, you don't have to climb up in the heavens to get to his attention now, or have some religious protocol. This is a time when God comes into your field, where you live, where you work, to make himself accessible and to surprise you with his very presence. Now, God may manifest himself many ways to you. He may come on your job. He may be in your classroom. He may come in your office. He may come in your home, your shop. But understand that during this month of transition, the month of Elul, this is the month clearly that God wants to meet with us and talk to us and deal with us in our everyday affairs of this life. That's why it's important to understand the times, like the children of Issachar did and the tribes of Judah, and what you need to be doing. There was a significance in understanding the times and the months. The Jews call the eye of the needle month. The month of Elul, the eye of the needle. And let me repeat that. The Jews call this the month of the needle month. This is the eye of the needle month. You're giving God the eye of the needle in your life. So that simply means that you're making a place for God. Even if it's only a small place, find a holy place, a place where it could be just you and him, and completely his, so that God can pour out to you his love and faithfulness. Now, I believe over these next 72 hours that this is a place that God's going to reveal himself right here during these next 72 hours for those that are tuned in to hear what God is saying in this hour. And so I want to end it by saying the month of Elul is associated with the Hebrew letter YUD, which means that God has appointed